This is Glenn Collins with the New York Times. I'm in Greenwood Cemetery, the 169-year-old monument in Brooklyn, New York. Around me are more than 1,000 gravestones, arranged in ranks as they are at Arlington and in Normandy at Colville-sur-Mer. Only these are the gravestones of Civil War veterans. Their remarkable history is just coming to light thanks to the efforts of hundreds of volunteers.
We ordered approximately 1,200, and that was just for men who were in either unmarked graves or had unreadable stones. And we have very close to 3,000 that we've found here.
Jeff Richman is historian at Greenwood Cemetery. He's led the volunteer effort to determine the number of Civil War veterans buried at the cemetery and to honor them with new grave markers provided by the Veterans Administration. Many of the original gravestones were missing, damaged, or obliterated by erosion.
So according to our maps, there should have been more stones in the soldiers' lot, and they just were not visible, and so we thought that it was possible that some of them might have sunk into the ground. And you can see that this is one of the stones that they found for Dr. Joachim, and so that's Conrad Joachim and his son Charles, 1816 to 1862 and 1844 to 1863, and so they both die during the Civil War.
I've been working on this project for 5 years. I started out with Jeff doing research work on the computer, checking the soldiers' names against the records in the cemetery, because they're all in old ledgers, going with the archives through the government, checking their names. And now that the stones are coming, what it feels to me is they're not forgotten. I'm your mother. You're welcome home. You're going to be remembered, and you're here.
During a recent Saturday, volunteers mapped the stones on display for a Memorial Day commemoration ceremony.
Double R.
The markers will then be planted on the graves.
W-A-G-N-E-R, Frederick, and 66th.
In doing these stones, I see someone who was wounded in the same battle my great-grandfather was wounded in. They might have known each other.
My great-great-grandfather is buried in Greenwood Cemetery, and when I heard about this project, I came to help. He fought in for the North. He mustered in East New York. He was a corporal in Company K, New York 47th Infantry. I did some research about a little over 10 years ago, and the death certificate indicated Greenwood Cemetery. I came here, and I found the location of his grave, because I found him in the register, but there was no stone there. And this is finally going to be placed on the grave. This will definitely put a cap on the end of the project for me.
We in our project, which has lasted almost 5 years now, we joke that it's lasted longer than the Civil War. We have found close to 3,000 Civil War veterans here. We think that there may be as much as another 6,000 or 7,000 here that we haven't found yet.
I've been to Gettysburg. I've had a lot of military people in my family. We won't go into that. Who's in Iraq? My husband's a Vietnam vet. So all this veterans in war, you're just an American. Me, basically, is not all the colonels and the majors and the brigadier generals. It's the lonely little private soldiers. Those are the heroes to me, the little quiet little boys that gave up their life. Someone remember.